I believe we've got the Maharashtra top cop who's looking into this case joining us right now. And Faye D'Souza with me in the Mumbai studios. Faye, over to you.
Thank you, Tanvi. We have Mr. Param Bir Singh. He's ADG, Law and Order, Maharashtra, live on the channel at this point. Mr. Singh, thank you for joining us. Good afternoon. We appreciate your time. My first question to you is this. What are the main charges that you're bringing against the 10 people that have been arrested in these cases? What are the most grievous charges off that list?
So the most grievous charges are involvement of in the unlawful activities and terror activities. We have registered a case under various sections of IPC and under the various sections of UOPA. So UOPA deals with providing and raising funds for the terror organization, unlawful organizations, being members of the banned organizations, association and spreading ideology of the banned organizations. So these are essentially the charges against these prominent accused whom we had raided and tried to arrest recently.
Is there also a charge here or a conspiracy to overthrow the government, overthrow the democracy, or assassinate the Prime Minister that you happen to be investigating at this point?
So some of the evidence that we have got so far does show some correspondence where they propose to eliminate political leadership in a Rajiv Gandhi style assassination. This is a correspondence from Rona Wilson to Prakash. Prakash is the person who corresponds on behalf of the Central Committee. So, and they also talk about creating lawlessness, breakdown of law and order, creating chaos in the country, and ultimately bringing down the lawfully established government of the country.
But you haven't brought a sedition charge or any other charge against these 10 people based on this particular information that you've picked up.
So, as I said, that we have got evidence about their unlawful activities being member of the terror organizations. And we are requesting their custodial interrogation. And once we investigate and we are given permission by the court, we would collect further evidence and bring any additional charges whichever are applicable to their activities.
But Mr. Singh, one of the questions that were raised 3 days ago when the arrest took place was if this case is pan-national and according to some of the things you read out in your press conference, now also perhaps international, should the NIA or the IB have been brought into this case?
I think Pune Police has done a fantastic job so far. And it is for the government to decide whether NIA should step in or not. But I think Pune Police so far has done a fantastic job. Unprecedented damage has been caused to the Maoist organization. And I must compliment the Pune Police for that.
There was also criticism that the Pune Police received for not being able to present a very convincing case to the Supreme Court 3 days ago. Why do you believe they were unable to convince the court? And do you believe you have enough evidence? And are you prepared for the next hearing?
Honorable Supreme Court has given a chance until 5th of September to present a cogent case before them to bring all the evidence that we have against these accused. And I do believe that we have a very, very strong case. And on 5th of September, we'll be presenting our case before the Honorable Supreme Court. And I'm sure the court will appreciate the evidence that we provide, and which is a very, very strong case for custodial interrogation of these accused. And I'm sure court will give us a favorable verdict in the case.
Mr. Singh, the other question that must be raised is that you've had, the Pune Police had one press conference yesterday, you've held a press conference
last question, please.
Yes. You are presenting the list of evidence that you media, before you present it to the Supreme Court. Why is that?
That was the demand from all the media channels, that we have not been sharing the evidence, we should come out and share. Today we have shared, now that is an allegation, or you're appreciating what we have done today?
Well, I'm asking, since the matter is sub judice before the Supreme Court, should the police be sharing the information with the media?
So we have shared the information which we thought was shareable, which must be shared with the media and with the citizens of the country without compromising the investigation of the case. So we have taken that call, we have come out, and I'm sure we should be able to convince a lot of people that we do have a very, very strong case. Thank you very much.
All right, Mr. Singh, many thanks for joining us there. That was the ADGP Law and Order of Maharashtra talking about why information is being shared with the police right now. He did say, of course, that he shared whatever he believed was shareable at this point and that they have enough evidence and conclusive evidence, according to him, to convince the Supreme Court to grant them custody on the 5th.